This was a major breach of trust, and I'm really sorry that this happened.
That is Facebook founder and CEO Mark Zuckerberg in a CNN interview apologizing for the data breach, where basically Facebook surveys were sent to turned over to Cambridge Analytica. And C4, there are a lot of people who are going on Facebook, announcing that I'm deleting my Facebook account.
A little too late. That's the horse being out of the barn at this point.
It's very sanctimonious of them and everything like that. But the question is, when you're on Facebook, do you expect complete privacy? Do you expect what you say to be, you know, used?
Well, the thing is, I'm not a big Facebook user. I mean, C4 Show is on Facebook.
Yes, it is.
But one of the things I expect, the same thing with emails. I would go back to the old technology and old ability of emails. I don't put anything in an email, Robert. I don't expect everybody in the world to read. When it comes to Facebook, this free entity that we go to, there's got to be a way for Facebook to monetize what they do. And the way they monetize it is they sell this data to different firms. Now, there were thousands of these firms like Cambridge Analytica who had apps that were able to go in and take the information from you, let's say, and then from that extrapolate that to all your friends and everybody else. Some 50 million Americans were hit by this. Now, should Facebook have had more controls for the information they were supposed to receive? Maybe, maybe not. But you, as a consumer, caveat emptor, the buyer beware, you should know that when you go in this vehicle, it's wide open.
And now Congress is getting involved.
They want to.
And Mr. Zuckerberg has said he'd be willing to testify.
Under certain conditions.
Under certain conditions before a House and Senate committee. And we know what that hearing is going to be like. And then Sheryl Sandberg and others, Biz Stone from Twitter, will probably be called in.
Well, the problem, Robert, is when that door gets open, and one of the things about the internet being the Wild Wild West is on the negative, you have a lot of different abuses. But on the positive, we are able to get information anywhere in the world with what's happening right now news-wise. What regulatory scheme will Congress come up with? Because we've seen this before in other industries.
Yes.
That then inhibits or keeps certain information from getting to people. And that's always been the concern about the internet. You have on one side the negatives that we just described.
Right.
But on the other side, you have the positives of people in certain parts of Africa who've never had information having access to it.
And there is the fear of government censorship whenever Congress
Absolutely.
Gets involved in this. And just, you know, my own sense with this is, and I saw this, I think it was the Florida Bar Association said, you know, dance like no one is watching, but post as if it's going to be read aloud in a deposition.
And I'm going to say again, I'm going to ask people, how do you expect this what you're getting for free, this access to Facebook, how do you expect them to monetize this other than the fact that they sell your information to individuals so they can utilize it? You must be the buyer. You
not
must be
not only your information, but your friends' information. And, you know, one thing is just you be safe as to what you post. I mean, the cat videos and the TV trivia quizzes that I post, I think are
priceless. Those
yeah.
are priceless.
Well, the cat videos,
I can't
yes.
wait for them, exactly.
Yeah, Jules 2 watching the snow and everything like that. Don't forget the C4 Encore
Thank
tonight
you, Robert.
At midnight. C4 back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090.